what about the man behind the woman? How do they keep these ladies going? And what do they think about pole dancing? Meet Jim Weissman, an accountant whose wife has been pole dancing since 2002. He tells us about the journey they've been on together ever since.
Hi, my name's James Weissman. My wife and I are the co-owners of Lifestyle Financial Services, Empowerment Through Exotic Dance, and Midwest Pole Dancing. Mary Ellen Weissman, I'm lucky enough to be married. I had the typical husband reaction. You want to get a pole and you want to dance on it? Yay. And my wife is the type of person that never does anything halfway. And if she was going to learn, she was going to learn it all.
Right.
So within the first month, she decided she was going to do home parties. And it wasn't that much longer than that that she said, okay, I want a studio. Home parties aren't good enough. First studio was actually the reception room of my accounting office. And now we have two locations. And the location in the accounting office actually consumes one whole day and every night of the week.
I asked Jim how he felt about changing his accounting office into a pole dance studio and what that was like for him.
I had big qualms of saying, I'll do this much, but no more.
Right.
And she'd get me to do that. And it wouldn't be a couple months later, she'd get me to take the next step, and I'd do what I said I wouldn't do before.
Okay.
And she was right in the beginning. Yeah. From 9 to 5, we have a conference room and reception room with very traditional pictures and furniture. And hardly anybody notices that all the furniture is on wheels. Come 4:30 for our 5 o'clock class, all the furniture gets wheeled into one of our bookkeeper's offices. All the pictures come down. And what used to be one of the offices is now a dressing room, and that's where all the equipment is stored. We bring out, set up 4 poles, change all the pictures in both rooms to something pole-oriented.
Yeah.
And it's a pole studio, which I should mention, when we knocked down the wall between the two rooms, we replaced it with a foldable wall.
Okay.
So during the day, there's still two rooms, and the wall folds back, and it's one big room.
What was once an accounting office is now a pole dance studio. Jim's enthusiasm is not just for the pole studio. He now offers his skills as an accountant at pole dance competitions.
I volunteered to be scorekeeper for several of them. So once the judges compiled the score, they said, since I was an accountant, I'd be the natural one. Okay, you add them all up. You're good with numbers. So Mary Ellen and I put together a spreadsheet that's automated with a bunch of macros, and we've now got it down where we can actually keep up with the contest as it goes. So within a couple minutes after the lance dancer leaving the stage and the judge is scoring her, we can tell you who placed first, second, and third. That's and give you a little printout. And it's a service we're offering to the industry, which is the attitude both Mary Ellen and I have taken about everything in the industry, is we need to help it like it's helped us.
Since Jim now understands the pole industry, he'd like to see some business owners take things a little more seriously.
Unlike a lot of other fields, the people in pole aren't business people first. They're pole dancers who happen to be good at pole dancing. Once more affluent, established people get into owning pole studios where they have assets to protect, they're going to be more and more concerned about doing things the right way and their potential liability. But there's going to be an American Debbie Plowman one day. And somewhere that does happen, and it's going to happen here too. And it's going to be bad for the entire pole industry if the owner of that studio isn't prepared to handle it in a professional manner.
With their experience and efforts combined, Jim and Mary Ellen have come up with their own pole dance certification program.
We wanted our certification to be different from everybody else's, and the fact it wasn't so much that we want to show you how to teach pole, we want to show you how to be a studio owner. So I wrote a short course, and we call Business Considerations, and everybody who takes our certification on the beginner intermediate level has to sit through a several-hour session with me. Yeah. According to the Small Business Administration, 80% of all new businesses die in the first year, and 80% of the remaining 20 die the second year. And the two reasons they quote for it is, number one is lack of money. Second reason is lack of good advice. So we're hoping to do something about the second reason for the people that go through our course.
It's no secret that Jim is very proud of his wife, Mary Ellen. So much so that he even makes his own t-shirts.
My Mary Ellen Weissman t-shirts? Well, I've steadfastly maintained that I am very proud to be the husband of Mary Ellen Weissman. So as many times as I can, I have Mary Ellen on my shirt. And for all pull events, I'm either wearing the company name or a Mary Ellen image. And frankly, even in my off time, I have several shirts that state that I'm the proud husband of a pole dancer, and her image is on all of them.
Jim Weissman is a serious man who is devoted to his wife and has discovered the pole dance industry like so many of us have. Although he finds it's extremely fun and he's made tons of new friends, he does leave us with one last thought at the end of our interview.
But as an insider in the pole industry, I sincerely hope everybody migrates their attitude toward it being something I do strictly for what I love and actually start treating it as a profession. Because I think all the students deserve that.